Hello, hello, my friend. Amner Hunter here from amnerhunter.com. Happy to spend some time with you in another video. This time around, I want to share with you the news of this cool freebie by Native Instruments in partnership with Izotope, right? Both of those companies are giving away the mastering and mixing equalizer. It's a module from Ozone 11, right? It's a mastering equalizer, but it can be also used on mixing, all right? So this is the Ozone equalizer, and right now it's part of the Complete Start bundle, and you can grab it for free. I'm not sure till when exactly, it's not specified, right? As usual, I will leave you the applicable links in the video description and the first comment, and I will also leave you timestamps in case that you want to move around between the mini segments of the video. And in this video, I want to walk you through the simple steps to get it to work, install this this plugin on your computer, right? And also talk a bit about its features. Before we begin with the content, let me invite you quickly to my website, amnerhunter.com, where you can grab some additional freebies, such as some free PDF guides and ebooks for music producers and guitar players. Also some free tools, such as some collections of guitar impulses, some collections of drum sample packs, among other utilities. And finally, don't forget to check out this channel or my blog, which I am updating almost every day with content like this. Let me know if you are here in the live chat. I am always very interested and happy to read your comments, questions, greetings, anything really. All right. So also you can leave me your comment after the live stream ended in the comment box down below. All right. So let's begin here with the steps to download and install this plugin. So go to the website and click on the link that I leave you in the video description, and it's gonna take you to this Native Instruments web page where you can claim your free gift, right? The Ozone 11 EQ, which is of course a module from the whole suite, which is Ozone 11 for mastering, right? And yeah, this equalizer, it's pretty cool. So I suggest you first to create an account here at Native Instruments website, right? You click here and you log in your existing account or register with a new account, right? After you have done that, you click here where it says download Ozone 11 EQ free, and it's gonna take you to this part of the website. If you are not logged in already, click here where it says get free software if you already have an account, okay? And it's gonna take you to this, so get Ozone 11 EQ, and after that it's gonna be deposited on your account, right? And afterwards you need to download the Native Access platform, which is free, where you manage and install all of your products, right? So you download it for Mac or Windows, in my case Windows, right? And you install the application, which is Native Access. You enter with your credentials and it's gonna look something like this, all right? You're gonna have all of the products from Native Instruments and others ready to install and stuff like that. And as you see here, it says new product has been added to your account. You can check it out in the new tab. So here in the new, I got a notification, and here you have deposited now the Ozone 11 equalizer's license, okay? So you click here where it says update or install, and it's gonna start downloading and installing the plugin, right? Just like that, very, very simple. And also, it's very important that you check out the installation path of Ozone 11 equalizer, because in my case, it installed the plugin elsewhere, and I needed to find that path in order for my DAW to follow that path and to me be able to set that path in my DAW for the DAW to recognize the plugin, right? So if you click here, installation paths, you're going to see exactly where the plugin was installed. And now you can go ahead and look for it using your DAW's path and folder, all right? So let's go to my DAW. Let's check out some of the features and controls of this plugin. All right. And let's check out here. Let's change, switch to my DAW. Okay, so I have here now Ozone 11 equalizer. I apologize because I am not able to show you some audio tests and audio demos. I am experiencing a bit of lag in this plugin. I need to fix something here on my computer. But anyway, this is a parametric equalizer. It's, of course, they mention and they say that is like for mastering, but it's also highly, highly usable and effective for mixing as well, right? So you can add a lot of EQ bands here. If you double click, you're gonna add bands, or if you click in this plus button, right, you're gonna start to add the different bands. And on each band, if you click on the dot, you're gonna be able to set that particular band to different EQ curves, right? You're gonna be able to use it as bell, low shelves, different types of low shelves, high shelves, low pass filters, high pass filters, right? And different types of with some added like resonances and brick wall, for instance. And also you're gonna see here, of course, the frequency that this band is applied to. Okay, and you can solo, of course, each one of the bands. You can close the band with this X. All right, and also the cool new features in Ozone 11, if you're not familiar, are a couple in this new version, right, which is Ozone 11. And this equalizer actually has those couple of features. First of all, you have the delta, right? With the delta, you can listen only like the difference between the equalized the difference between the processing of the equalizer and the processing without and no processing of this equalizer. With the delta, you can hear that difference, and it's gonna sum all of the bands in this delta, right? So everything that all of the bands are doing, you're gonna be able to hear only that in this delta mode. You have analog and digital EQ curves. The analog EQ curves are a bit more musical, a bit more broad, so to speak. And also one cool new thing in this equalizer than that there's not in other versions, previous versions, is this. You have the stereo option to process and affect the whole stereo spectrum. You can also affect the mid and side image and left or right as well. But this transient sustain, it's pretty cool, right? Because you can apply EQ only to the transient, which is like the peak, the initial impact of any given instrument, or you can affect only the sustain with the equalizer, right? You can affect only the tail, like the decay of any given signal. And this plugin divides the audio into two, which is transient and sustain. Pretty cool. And you can also listen and solo each one of those with this S that you have here. Turn off and turn on. You can also link the channels like that. And yeah, pretty cool feature added. And this feature of the transient sustain was first used by Eventide on the split EQ. And now some other companies have adopted that same feature and philosophy, right? Also, one cool thing is this amount control. So if you decrease or increase the amount control, you're going to affect all of the bands, how much it's being applied, right? So for instance, there is zero amount, and the more you start to increase this, all of the bands are going to be exaggerated at the same time, okay? And you can get up to 200% here, and it's going to add a ton of more processing on each band. And so, yeah, with one control, you can pretty much adjust universally the EQ curves. You have also a meter and a very, very useful gain match here. So yeah, pretty cool equalizer. Like I said, very good for mastering, which is the initial way of doing it, but it's also very usable and effective on mixing. So yeah, let me know what you think of this equalizer. I am always very happy to read your comments, questions, and any opinion that you might have, it's highly appreciated. And so yeah, there you go, my friend. That's the video for today. Before we leave, let me invite you one last time to my website, amnerhunter.com, where you can grab some additional freebies, such as some free PDF guides and ebooks for music producers and guitar players, also some free tools, such as some collections of guitar impulses, some collections of drum sample packs, among other utilities. And finally, don't forget to check out this channel or my vlog, which I am updating almost every day with tons of content like this, mostly free resources for home studio music producers and audio enthusiasts. All right, so take care. It was a pleasure. I hope to see you very soon in the next video. Bye bye.